Start to start. Welcome you all. Today's last speaker is Professor Philip Korableu, and he is going to talk on quantals, quasars, and co-cyclic knot invariants. Professor, please carry on.
Thank you. Yes. One moment. Yes. Okay. I would like to start from the very classical subject, knots colorings. Today we already meet some notions about it, but I will repeat in any case. Okay, the set X with a binary operation is called quandl if it satisfies to the following three axioms. The first axiom for any A multiplied to A is equal to A. Second axiom, for any AB, there exists unique X such that XA is equal to B. And the third axiom is self-distributivity, AB multiply C is equal to AC multiply BC. Sometimes quandl is called distributive groupoid, but quandl term more often we will use it. These axioms comes from knot diagram colorings in the following way. Consider a knot diagram and choose some coloring of the diagram X by elements of the set X, and say that the coloring is proper if at any positive crossing the color of the input bottom arc multiplied to the color of the top arc is equal to the color of the bottom output arc. And at the negative crossings, the similar equation holds. Then it turns out that if the set is finite and the operation satisfies quandl axioms, then the number of proper colorings of the knot diagram does not change under the master move. And thus we can consider the set call of D, which consists of all proper colorings of the diagram. And the order of the set is a correctly defined knot invariant. But the similar algebraic structure can be obtained if we consider instead of arcs colorings of the diagram, consider colorings of the diagram areas. So let Y is a set with ternary operation. It means the map from Y times Y times Y to Y. And consider a diagram of a knot and fix some coloring of this diagram areas, and say that the coloring of areas is proper if at any positive crossing the result of fixed ternary operation for the colors A, B, C in clockwise direction is equal to the color of the fourth area D in the neighborhood of the positive crossing. And for negative crossing, the similar, but in counterclockwise direction, ABC is equal to D. And the question, when the number of area colorings, the number of area colorings does a change under randomizer moves. So this is the answer. The ternary operation should satisfy to the following two axioms. The first axiom say that the equation ABC is equal to D should uniquely solvable over each variable ABC. It means for any BC and D, there is a unique A which satisfies this equation. For any ACD, there is unique B, and so, and the same for C. And there's a second, for any ABCD from Y, these two equations should be true. Yes. And if the ternary operation satisfies to this axiom, then the number of proper corollaries does a change under the master move. So we can consider S4 quantal the set of all proper corollaries, and the order of the set is also Knot invariant. Yes, we say that this set with ternary operation is quasoid. This is a new notion. Sometimes in the literature it calls Nebridovsky tribracket, but I will use quasoid. It's more simple to pronounce. Some examples, some basic example. At first, at any group, it's possible to introduce the quantal operation and quasoid operation. Quantal operation defined by this equality, A multiplied to B is equal to B A B inverse. Quasoid operation is equal to A B inverse C. In fact, the quantal operation comes from Wirtingen presentation of the Knot group. And this comes from Den presentation of the Knot group. The second example, quantal. Let X will be the set of all polynomials with integer coefficients and maybe negative powers, and define the operation A multiplied to be equal to TA plus one minus TB. And then this is quantal operation. In the quantal is called Alexander quantal. The similar is possible for quasoid. If we consider the set of polynomials with two variables, also maybe with negative powers, and define the ternary operation by this way, ABC is equal to TA minus TUB plus UC, then this will be quasoid and it calls linear quasoid. But of course, there are many other examples of quantals and quasoids, finite and infinite, and so on. Next, I would like to describe the canonical procedure, also well known, which allows to construct a chain complex for any finite quantal. Okay, let X with operation be a finite quantal. Then consider two abelian groups, Cn. This is a group generated by all finite sequences of the elements from our quantal, and En generated by all sequences where there is at least one pair of sequential elements which are equal. Of course, En is a subgroup of Cn. Then to define boundary homeomorphism for the chain complex, we need the following two maps, Ln and Rn, from Cn to Cn minus one. Ln defined by this formula, it defines on the basis of the Cn, and it equals to the sum of n summands with alternating signs. And each summand is a sequence of n minus one element. From the number e plus one, the elements are the same as the argument. And the first I minus one elements are the result of the multiplication original one and the element x I. The element with the number I is skipped from this sequence. The formula for the Rn is similar, but more simple because the sequence simply drop the element x, y. These two functions has very natural geometric interpretation. Left picture for the Ln and the right for the Rn. So how it should be understand this picture? The colors of the top points in this diagram, this is the argument of the Ln. And the bottom colors are the is summand, and these colors uniquely defined by the property that the coloration of the diagram is proper. And that's all. For the same for Rn. Yes, the same for Rn. Next, we can introduce two different boundary homomorphism. Dn minus, which is equal to the difference between Ln and Rn, and Dn plus, which is equal to the sum of these two maps. And both of them define the boundary homomorphism from the factor groups Cn over En to Cn minus 1 over En minus 1. And in this way, we obtain two chain complexes. Negative, where all boundary homomorphism are differences of Ln and Rn, and positive chain complex. It's possible to study this chain complex from an algebraic point of view. For example, calculate homology groups or maybe cohomology groups for corresponding co-chain complex and so on. But for our purpose, we need only some elements from this complex to extract a knot invariant. So it can be done in the following way. Let X is a finite quantum and fix two cocycles, phi minus from the negative version of the cochain complex, which is correspond to chain complex, negative chain complex, and phi plus from this is two cocycle from positive cochain complex. And then we can define the knot invariant by the following formula. How it can be calculated? So we should fix any proper coloring of the diagram arcs of the knot, and then calculate at each crossing the value phi minus from the colors of the arcs in the neighborhood of the positive crossing and the similar in the negative crossing. Then take these values to these signs, plus for positive, minus for negative crossing, sum over all the crossings of the diagram, and this sum will be the color weight, which is denoted by W xi phi minus. And for each such weight, we draw a monom x in this power, and then sum over all proper colorings of the knot, of the diagram of the knot, and we will obtain some polynomial with one variable, and this polynomial is a knot invariant. And in the same way, it's possible to define the invariant for two cocycle from positive cochain complex. The formula is similar, difference in the weight of crossing points. To calculate it, we additionally need the checkerboard coloring of the diagram, diagram areas, such that the outer area, for example, is black. And then at each crossing point, calculate these four values. In positive crossing, take phi plus or minus phi plus, and in negative crossing, minus phi plus and plus phi plus, with respect where black areas are in the neighborhood of this crossing. And then, as in previous case, sum over all proper colorings and obtain another polynomial knot invariant. These two knot invariants are well known and called cocycles knot invariants. The similar procedure can be done for quasoids when we color areas instead of arcs. And okay, let me describe the difference What is the differences? Okay, let y is a quasoid with some fixed ternary operation. Define groups Cn for this quasoid is the sequence of n plus one elements, y0 and so on, yn. And En is a sequence of also, is a group generated by sequence of also n plus y elements, but this element should satisfy, this sequence should satisfy the condition that there are a triple of sequential elements, yg minus one, yg, yg plus one, such that the result of ternary operation is equal to the central element, element yg. Of course, En here is also subgroup for of the Cn. Next, we also should define two maps, the some analog of L and R maps, lambda and rho. These maps defined in the similar way on the basis it equals to the sum with alternating signs of some sequences of the length n, and the same for Rn, rho n, the sequence of n plus one elements maps to the sum of sequence of n elements. How these sequences are defined? Here are formulas for these elements. They defined by some recurrent property. For example, for lambda n from g and which is greater than I minus one, the element is the same as in the argument. And all other elements calculated from the previous ones by the applying ternary operations. And the similar formulas for the rho n map. But more convenient to understand these two maps in the geometric interpretation because it's very similar to the quantum case. So left picture for lambda, right picture for rho. And again, the argument is colors of the areas at the top, and the elements of the is summand is the colors of the bottom. And these colors also uniquely defined by the property that the coloration of this diagram should be proper by elements of our quasoid. And the same for the map rho. And then, as for Quandl, we can define two boundary homomorphism D minus and D plus from factor groups Cn over En to Cn minus one over En minus one. And also we obtain two chain complexes for finite quasoid, a negative and positive. And also it's possible to extract Knot invariants from cocycles of this chain and corresponding co-chain complexes. Okay. For this, take fix two cocycles, psi minus and psi plus, and define the negative version of the quasoid cocycle invariant in the following way. Again, fix a proper coloring by our quasoid. Calculate the weight of each crossing point, sum over all crossing points. This will be the weight of the coloring, sum over all proper colorings, and obtain a polynomial Knot invariant. And the same formula for the positive version of this invariant. As for Quandl, we should fix the checkerboard coloring of areas. This coloring is independent with colorings of areas by elements of our quasoid. Yes. And then calculate crossing weights, sum, write the monome, and sum over all proper colorings and obtain another polynomial connoting variant. So next I would like to describe some version of mixed cocycle connoting variant, which use S cocycles for quandals and cocycles for quasoids. But before, let me introduce the notion of projection. What is projection? Let X be a quandal, Y is a quasoid, and the projection is a map from I times Y to X, which satisfies to the following two axioms for any ABC P from A, and the result ABC is equal to P from BC, and P ABCC is equal to PAB multiply in quandal P BC. Here's the geometric interpretation. Here's a geometric interpretation of the projection, the left picture. If we have a proper coloring, any coloring of areas by quasoid, then by using P, we can assign a quandal colors for this arc by using colors of the quasoid from right and left with respect to this arc. So the projection induces the coloring of the area arcs by area colorings. And the right picture describes axioms in the following sense. If you have a proper colorings of the areas near crossing, then colors A and B induce the color of the arc PAB, B, C induce the color of this arc. These two colors, A, B, C, and C induce this color, and A, A, B, C induce this color. So the first axiom say that the color of the top arc are the same. PBC is equal to this value. And the second axiom say that if that's the result of multiplication of these two colors is equal to this color. So it means that proper colors in coloring of the areas induce the proper coloring of arcs. So we can introduce the induced map from proper colorings of quasoid to proper colorings of the quandal for our diagram. Here's two simple examples for the group. Projection can be defined by this formula. And for the Alexander quandal and the linear quasoid with one variable, projection can be defined by this formula for any x. We can get any x, and this formula will define the projection from quasoid to Alexander quandal. Here I will skip. Here I would like to say that projection also induce the chain map from chain complex of quasoid for two chain complex of any quandal. For negative or positive, doesn't matter. And the last one is the formula for two combined versions of the cocycle invariance. How it should calculate it for the minus version of the invariant, for example. We should enumerate all proper colorings by quasoid, then calculate all corresponding proper coloring induced on the arcs, these colorings by quandal, and then calculate the weight of each coloring by quasoid and write this monom, and by corresponding quandal coloring and write this monom, and then sum over all proper colorings by quasoid. And the same for the positive version. Okay, I think that I will stop here. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Professor Philip. Any questions?
Hello. So in the definition of cuboid, when we are considering, so basically we are considering regions and then we are defining relations. So is the definition, the relation dependent upon the permutation of how we are reading the
Excuse me, please repeat the question again.
Okay, so in the definition, what we are doing is we are assigning the generators to the regions. So we can have different permutation, as in I can read ABC is equal to D. So we can also read BAD is equals to C. So is there a
relation? Of course, yes. Yes, I understand the question. There are different methods how to read the colors of areas, but more convenient way, as described in the picture. We start in the neighborhood of any crossing point. There is input area and outer area. Then we start from the right, from this direction, and read by clockwise direction or counterclockwise direction for negative point. Maybe it's possible to read in from other area in some other direction, but in this approach the formulas are symmetry and simple.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Excuse me.
Mm-hmm.
I have a question. Do you have any example which shows cosoid cocycle invariant is stronger than Kandro cocycle invariant? And also another example which shows Kandro cocycle invariant is stronger than cosoid cocycle invariant?
The strength of the cocycle invariant depends on two things. The first is the cardinality of the quandl or quasoid, and the second selected two cocycle. Of course, it's easy to construct an example when we take the very weak quandl and big quasoid, and then of course quasoid invariant will be more power, and the same in the other direction, of course. Maybe you ask something different.
Yeah, Kandro coloring number is the same.
If we take quandl and quasoid of the same order,
coloring numbers, yes, and only cocycle invariant can be distinguished, but Kandro cocycle cannot, and cosoid cocycle can. Say example.
If you ask, is any example of two different nodes which cannot be distinguished by any quandl, but can be these two nodes distinguished but by any quasoid? No, I don't know such example. And the same for other direction. Yes, I don't know.
Oh, thank you.
For small quandls and quasoids with cardinality 4 or 5, for example, the power of the proper colors counting invariant is quite weak. It's weak invariant in general.
Okay.
Yes.
Any more questions? If there are no questions, let's thank the speaker.